Good morning, students. In our last class, we have started the lesson National Movement in India, Partition and Independence 1939 to 1947. In that, we have completed some part of the lesson, and today we are going to complete the remaining part. The Pakistan Resolution. Many people now felt that the separate governing arrangements were needed for regions where Muslims were in majority. For example, the Urdu poet Muhammad Iqbal, the writer of the song Sare Jahan Se Acha Hindustan Hamara, spoke of a need for a north to west Indian Muslim state in his presidential address to the Muslim League in 1930. So what happened here? So many people felt that the separate governing arrangements were needed for regions where Muslims were in majority. So for example, who is the poet? He was a Urdu poet, Muhammad Iqbal. He has written the song, What Sare Jahan Se Acha Hindustan Hamara. So this song, generally we all know, this song was written by Muhammad Iqbal. He was a Urdu poet. So he speak about a need of a north to west Indian Muslim state, and in his presidential address to the Muslim League in 1930. So the name Pakistan or Pakistan, from Punjab, Afghanistan, Kashmir, Sindh and Baluchistan was coined by a Punjabi Muslim student at Cambridge. Chaudhry Rehmat Ali. This young student wrote pamphlets between 1933 and 1935. He described a separate national status for this new entity. No one took Rehmat Ali seriously in the 1930s, especially the League and other Muslim leaders, who dismissed this idea merely as a student's dream. So what happened? The name Pakistan or Pakistan, so this was coined by a Punjabi Muslim student at Cambridge. So what was the name of that student? Chaudhry Rehmat Ali. So this young student, what did he do? He wrote a pamphlet between 1933 to 1935, and he desired a separate national status for this new entity. And what did he do? But no one took Rehmat Ali seriously in 1930s. So what did they thought? Especially the League and other Muslim leaders, they have dismissed his idea, thinking as if it is a student's dream. Then the political situation in India changed when British started following the policy of divide and rule. Congress failed to address the fears of Muslims. On 23rd March 1940, the Muslim League moved a resolution and demanded autonomy for the parts of the subcontinent where Muslims were in majority. This ambiguous resolution never mentioned partition or Pakistan. However, in later years, it became known as the Pakistan Resolution. People were thinking of different ways to solve the issues raised by the League, and a new nation started, or a new nation state of Pakistan was one among these alternatives. But since the discussions and negotiations were not working out, the idea of a separate nation state of Pakistan became stronger. The Congress was unable to fulfill the demands of M.A. Jinnah, leader of the Muslim League. So here what happened? The political situation in India was changing when British started following the policy of divide and rule. And the Congress also failed to address the fears of Muslims. So what happened on 23rd March 1940? The Muslim League moved a resolution and they demanded autonomy for the parts of the subcontinent where Muslims were in majority. So this ambiguous resolution, what happened? It never minded partition on Pakistan. So later it became known as the Pakistan Resolution. Then people were thinking of different ways to solve the issues raised by the League. And a new nation state of Pakistan was one among these alternatives. But since the discussions and negotiations were not working, so the idea of a separate nation state of Pakistan became stronger. As these people were trying to convince the government, they are not getting convinced. So what happened? These discussions and negotiations were not working. So the idea of a separate nation state was strong. It became strong in the minds of people. So the Congress was unable to fulfill the demands of M.A. Jinnah, who is the leader of Muslim League. So from 1940 to 46, the League convinced Muslim masses about the benefits and need for a separate nation. Peasants could imagine a state where Hindu zamindars and moneylenders did not exploit them. Traders, businessmen and job seekers could think of a state where competition from Hindu traders, businessmen and job seekers would not be there. There would be greater religious freedom. There would be freedom for the Muslim elite to run the government the way they wanted. From 1942 to 1945, most Congress leaders were in jail. The League made us for the time to build its base among the people. So what happened here? From 1940s to 46, this League convinced Muslim masses about the benefits and need for a separate nation. And also peasants also could imagine a state where Hindu zamindars and moneylenders did not exploit them. So even we all fought for separate Telangana. So what the people were saying here, if we get separate Telangana, we'll be having more opportunities of jobs and we don't have a competition between these AP people. All those things, when they explained, even we also thought that when these people will go to their own state, even we also will be getting so many opportunities. In the same way, here these people also, if they get separate nation state, even they also will not have any competition. They thought like that. And the traders, businessmen and job seekers could think of a state where competition from Hindu traders, businessmen and job seekers would not be there. So even these traders, jobs, persons, and these traders, they all thought that there will not be any competition for them. And there would be greater religious freedom. They thought if it gets separated, even we don't have, we'll be having a greater religious freedom in the country. So there would be freedom for the Muslim elite to run the government the way they wanted. So from 1942 to 45, most of the Congress leaders were in jail. So what happened? The League made use of the time to build its base among the people. So who will make the British quiet India? Who will make the British quit India? By 1941, Japan had started expanding into Southeast Asia. This was clear threat to Indian terrorists war. So Indian territories as well. the British wanted Indian people to support it in the war against Japan. In March 1942, Prime Minister Churchill was persuaded to send one of his ministers, Sir Stamford Cripps, to India to try and make a compromise with Gandhi and the Congress. But these talks failed about the Congress insisted that the Viceroy should first appoint an Indian as the defense member of his executive council. So what happened? So by 1941, Japan had started expanding into Southeast Asia. So it was clear threat to Indian territories as well. So when this Japan was started expanding to Southeast Asia, even the Indian territories also was having threat. So the British wanted Indian people to support it in the war. So with against whom? Against Japan, British want Indians also to fight, means to support in the war. So in March 1942, Prime Minister Churchill, what did he do? Was persuaded to send one of his ministers. Who was he? Sir Stamford Cripps, to India to try and make a compromise with Gandhi and the Congress. So Prime Minister Churchill, he sent one of his ministers, Sir Stamford Cripps, to India to make a compromise between Gandhi and the Congress. But these talks failed after the Congress insisted that the Viceroy should first appoint an Indian as the defense member of the Executive Council. So I think till here you have understood the class. If you have any doubts, you can message me, and we'll be continuing the remaining part of the lesson in the next session. Thank you. Have a good day.